Okay, today we're at an abandoned funerary home, I guess. Question is how to get in, but I think this window might be very awesome. And then close it maybe and then get down. We got in. Tricky.
Someone threw that open.
Oh yeah. That's an easier window. It's stuck up.
That is Tram's bedoel.
Yeah. Okay, let's look around. So, used to be a funerary home. Here you have all the pieces to lay out with even a price tag on it. One with me to you bear. They have all the clothes. All types of clothes.
All the flower arrangements.
Yeah. And a lot of these shirts. I don't know why, but for the people to rent, maybe?
Oh, yeah, probably.
It was an option, yeah. Oh, so that window's open too. I think so.
And that door is open?
Yeah, this door is
open. Or we go around because I think there's another door.
You never know if there's any alert alarms still active. It has been abandoned since 2015 though, so. Gravestone.
Mm-hmm.
Really.
That's open.
Let's see.
Holy shit. The morgue. This is a morgue.
Here I can still hear the electricity. Yeah, this is the morgue.
What the fuck?
So this is the small baby coffin.
Yeah, this is definitely a morgue.
Couple of urbex setups, as you can see.
Jesus Christ.
This used to be the ovens, I think.
The incinerator oven.
Yeah.
And that's the entrance.
Yeah, that's the other entrance, which we luckily didn't take.
That's really sad.
Somebody tried to open this door too.
Yeah, and failed.
Yeah.
That's really small. I don't even think you can crawl through that.
Somebody we know did crawl through it. I don't know why.
Child.
No.
It's the easiest way.
Person we know did it, so.
Wait a second.
Just an empty space, really. That's the tank for the incinerator, I think, or something.
Let's do that.
Yeah. That could be the egg pot. So there's a biker's route nearby and we heard voices, but just a cycling route. Thank goodness it's just a cycling route. I mean, a lot of people have done it. This one in the last couple of days, so. Let's do lift the coffins into the car. Yeah. That's a wrapped coffin.
Two wrapped coffins. I think.
I think that's the stretcher just. Pillows and some blankets to put in the coffins.
Some iron coffins.
A wooden one over here. Which way does it go? Oof. Opens. Yeah, so there's not much left in it, so it's pretty hard on the outside. But that one's pretty too. For a little child. Another one.
Oh.
A wheelchair.
A wheelchair, indeed. And then the offices.
Administration.
Administration office.
Normal.
Waiting room. A regular waiting room. Looks like a hospital. Waiting room,
like
registration office.
Yeah.
Administration. Social home. Oven. 1, 2, 3. 3 ovens.
Yeah.
Cremation room. That's the room we entered in.
Yeah.
We have a big one there. 2 waiting rooms. Binetan. This is a big place.
Yeah.
It is.
Or maybe the room for the coffee.
No, this is just.
Sometimes when you cremate people, you also have coffee there.
And not only that, but they have an uitvaart. I don't know the name in English.
The funerary services are like.
Yeah, that's kept here, so they could roll it up here.
Yeah, the last. Yeah.
Yeah, the last wish, whatever. And then
last time you see the dead here, person, basically.
And then you normally stand here, the priest, and have people sit over there.
Yeah.
Waiting rooms over there, and oh wow.
Damn, the offices.
There's another waiting room.
There's some urns.
Some washer, apparently. Yeah. This is a small waiting room.
Yeah. And you have these though. Look at that.
Jesus.
Just a collection of.
This is so much good. This is insane.
And even an urn. It has a name on it, the urn.
What?
Urn has a name on it.
There are graves here with a name on it. Gravestones with a name on it.
Yeah, I saw that too. Try to avoid the names.
It has a name, that has a name, that has a name.
But I still need to be engraved.
Yeah.
This is pretty. And a little teddy bear. So I'm guessing for a child.
Some birds as well.
Yeah. Yeah, because over here, I'm not gonna open it, but it literally has the date of cremation and everything
this
on it.
This one is open. I don't know if this one is a date, but.
Yeah, that's just a typical.
It's an empty one.
Yeah.
I think it's empty, otherwise, I don't know. Respect, I wouldn't open anything that's.
Yep. That's a pretty one. This one?
No. That one's also pretty.
Even a baby picture. Yeah. There's a baby picture here.
We have lights.
There shall be light, they said. I'm surprised they didn't shut off the electricity yet.
Yeah, that means.
It's been 6 years.
And they should still pay for this shit.
Yeah.
cremation room. Oh, ceremony room, sorry.
So this is the main entrance, I guess, because this is some sort of atrium.
They had a fountain.
This one is a cool coffin.
Coffins.
Yeah. Look at that.
Jesus.
That's an expensive one.
You can 600 euros, you can be
I mean, you can tell that it's gonna be expensive.
Yeah.
Because of the painting. It's insane that they left it here. Those are all toilets, I guess.
That's a lot of toiletry.
And I heard something.
That's a lot of rooms. Charles' room, changing room.
Kitchen?
Yeah. Small kitchenette.
Can I just strip it and take it to the apartment?
We don't even have an apartment. Holy fuck.
What?
I thought this place was locked up.
Yeah?
Why is there a car driving on a private area?
I have no idea.
Oh, it definitely saw me.
You think?
Fuck yes. Yeah, I think so. It definitely saw me.
Is it still there?
It stopped.
Yeah, we need to get out.
Yep, it stopped.
Attempt number two.
Part two. Yeah, so we're not alone here now.
No, we're definitely not alone.
So, I sprinted through this entire building and jumped out of the window.
Yeah.
Because some fucker parked his car at the front entrance.
Yeah. So basically where we stopped in the previous one was exactly when we saw a car drive by.
What was that?
And it stopped in front.
What's that place?
Over there. God. Why would you do that? Nope. This isn't there. I saw them. And this one we did already. I saw them there over there. They have a backpack. So definitely not security, because security wouldn't be wearing a backpack. This we haven't done yet. At least not this part.
I've not done this.
Because here you have
pillows.
Pillows and blankets.
And our waiting room.
It's a big building.
Yeah, it's enormous. I'll move right here. Because this is where I saw
it. Yeah.
Okay, so we stopped here.
Yeah.
And there you can see the beautiful little car.
Yeah. If you look closely, they parked over there. Which, pro tip, don't park in front of an urbex location or you give other urbexers a heart attack.
It's literally as if it's a hell.
Hmm?
Is it locked down?
No. Oh. Still filming?
It's literally a Sunday, the day after then.
Yeah. It's an industry. This
we
is
sneak the... inside, they just.
Yeah, we snuck inside and they just parked their car in front.
Or just take this to the apartment.
Just take a couch. So yeah, right over there. Freaking in front.
This is locked, right?
We're not going in there. And I'm not filming it either because the name was on it.
Waar zijn dan die veel witte tassen op de muur staan? Die zijn nog
I don't know which ones you mean.
The picture you sent me earlier.
Show me a sec. So one last room we didn't find before. Just all flowers laid out.
Thank you.
I just missed your jump. Nope. So that's
there we go. Back outside. This is it for this episode and for this location.
Yeah, and for this week.
We'll see you in the next one.
Bye.
See ya.
What the fuck?
Die kist is naar hier verplaatst.
Die beelden ook.
What the fuck?
Deze vind ik creepy.